An important part of Indian culture since the dawn of civilization has been the yagya. In fact, our ancestors' prowess in understanding advanced mathematics is best understood through its use in yagya. The Sulba Sutras, the oldest surviving mathematical texts, they exhibit an understanding of geometry, fractions and exponents written around 3000 years ago. Their primary purpose was construction of fire altars for the yagya. And the most famous yagya, seen often in key stories, is the Ashwamedha yagya, the fourth and last of the main yagya that a successful king did in their progression to a respected emperor. It was used by rulers to prove their undisputed claim on territory. The method to conduct the yagya is described in the Yajurveda. It is a year-long endeavor, so it begins with setting up a camp with a fire altar and the surrounding structures made with very precise measurements. A white horse of the best breed available, satisfying various conditions described in the Yajurveda's Upanishad Brihadaranyak, was then worshipped and released, accompanied by the king's warriors to wander for a period of 1 year. The horse was to be protected at all costs, but not directed in any way. Whatever territory was traversed by the horse would belong to the king conducting the yagya, unless a rival could dispute the king's authority by challenging the warriors accompanying the horse. Back at the camp, daily rituals will continue for the entire duration. After 1 year, if no enemy had managed to kill or capture the horse, the animal would be guided back to the camp. It would then be worshipped again, then sacrificed, and the king would be declared as the undisputed ruler of all the land traversed by it. The 14th Parva of the Mahabharata, named the Ashwamedhika Parva, is so named because of this yagya. After the Kurukshetra war, Lord Krishna urges Yudhishthir, the newly crowned king, to conduct it to prove his sovereignty, and Arjun subsequently goes on his famous world conquest. It makes multiple appearances in the Ramayana as well. When sage Vishwamitra is taking Ram and Lakshman to his ashram in Balakand, he talks to them about their ancestors. He explains how the Ashwamedha horse being stolen from King Sagar's ritual led to a series of events that shaped the world and ultimately led to King Bhagirath bringing Ganga to earth. Then much later, Ram conducts the yagya in Uttarakhand, and that is the horse that is held by Lav and Kush, sparking the conflict that culminates in Lav and Kush telling their story in Ram's court and eventually revealing they are his sons. Through the ages, the Ashwamedha Yagya has been conducted by many iconic kings, such as Bharat, Dushyant, Puru, Parikshit, and many more. A king conducting 100 successful Ashwamedha Yagyas also held special significance, as that made the conductor comparable to Lord Indra. This is the reason Lord Indra steals the horse from King Sagar's yagya in the first place. And of course, King Mahabali was conducting his 100th Ashwamedha yagya when Lord Vishnu in his 5th avatar Vaman comes to liberate him. He also stopped King Prithu, the first ruler of earth, from doing his 100th yagya, saying it'll make him arrogant. In the modern era, the Ashwamedha yagya was conducted by kings in the Gupta Empire. Both Samudragupta and Kumaragupta after him had currency dedicated to the Ashwamedha horses to show their success at it. The last known Ashwamedha yagya was conducted by Raja Savai Jai Singh of Ajmer in 1741. It has been perhaps one of the most important tools for both territorial and economic expansion in our itihasa.